Hello and welcome to the Visio Plan Comparison. My name is Chanel Lelich and I'm the Worldwide VTSP for Visio. In this presentation, I will just give you a brief overview of different Visio plans we have and what each plan is meant for or which user should probably choose which plan. Now, this can only be just general recommendations. Please always talk to your user to see which Visio plan might be the best plan for them. So in this plan comparison, we will go through all the different Visio plans which are available and then also discuss how they are given to the user or how Visio users are consuming them. So what's important to understand is that we have two different licensing options or ways. One is the old on-premise licensing, and the other one is the new cloud-based licensing. So in the cloud, we have, in general, two licenses you can license or purchase. And these are called Visio Plan 1 and Visio Plan 2. Now, please note, there is no version number assigned with them. So they always come without a version number, just a plan number. There is also on-prem licensing, and there you will see Visio Standard or Visio Professional. If you hear the phrases Visio Standard or Professional, that always means it's an on-prem licensing because they always come with a version number. So it's Visio Standard 2016, Visio Professional 2019, and similar. Now, both on-premise licenses also always include a desktop application. There is no browser-based environment, but there is always a desktop application. Basically, Visio Standard and Visio Professional share the same product. Visio Professional adds templates, stencils, and add-ons for more sophisticated and more complex diagram types. Visio Plan 1 is a cloud-based license, and it's only running in the browser, which means it exists only as a web app. So there is no deployment necessary, and you can just open your browser, and you're good to go. Visio Plan 2 includes Plan 1 and adds a desktop application in addition to what Plan 1 already has to offer. The desktop application will be, from a feature point of view, somewhere a little bit above Visio Professional. So you will get all the features of Visio Professional plus some cloud exclusive features which only are available if you purchase Visio Plan 2. Now, there is also something I'd like to point out, and that is the difference between a product name and a technology name. If you hear the phrases Visio for the web or Visio web app, that means you're just talking about a Visio running in the browser. It doesn't indicate a product you can purchase. Now, as of now, we have covered one Visio product which is a Visio web app or Visio for the web type application, and that is Visio Plan 1. We will learn about another one very soon. So again, on-prem licensing always adds standard or professional and always adds a version number. Cloud licensing never adds a version number and it only gives you a plan number, so Plan 1 or Plan 2. Plan 1, pure browser-based plan. Plan 2, same as Plan 1, plus a few additional features and templates, and of course, a desktop application. So the new comer in the Visio plan world is Microsoft Visio in Microsoft 365, or as we call it, Visio for Everyone. It is a Visio license added to every user in one of the specifically supported plans. It is fully browser-based and it delivers basic features and diagram types. I'd like to point out that it's not meant for a regular Visio user, but for an organizational user who now and then needs to create a diagram. These are the plans where Visio in Microsoft 365 is automatically added and automatically active. You don't have to activate it. You don't have to purchase it. It's part of the core license. And as you see, all the big business plans and many business standard business plans are included, and also the enterprise plans, of course. So it's practically available everywhere. Now, Visio in Microsoft 365 only support the following diagram types. There is no extension, there is no additional diagram types. And as you see from the diagram types, it's meant for the entry-level user. It's meant for the user who just needs to create a basic diagram for standard corporate communication and organizational communication, but it's not meant to be a, let's say, more sophisticated type of tool. However, it ensures that every user in your organization will always be able to view and consume and comment and collaborate on a Visio diagram. So this is the plan comparison covering all the existing plans from a feature point of view. So as you see, collaboration and sharing is available from professional on in all the plans, just not in Visio Standard. Intelligent diagramming is available again in most of the plans automatically. User experience also the same, just keep in mind, Visio and Microsoft 365 and Visio Plan 1 are browser-based plans. Standard support also included in most of the plans. Data connectivity, keep in mind, only in Visio Professional and in Visio Plan 2. Now, connected diagrams can be saved in Visio Plan 1, for example, and they will keep updating. But to define such a connected diagram, you need Visio Professional or Visio Plan 2. Only the on-prem licensing and Visio Plan 2 give you a desktop application. The other plans are purely browser-based plans. Now, from a diagram type point of view, you will see that Visio in Microsoft 365 already has more templates than Visio Standard, for example. So you will see that Microsoft Visio in Microsoft 365 was able to cover, I would say, 90% of the diagramming needs of the non-regular Visio user. The default plan for a standard organizational user who doesn't have, let's say, needs for very sophisticated diagrams should and would be Visio Plan 1. That's the default plan for the whole organization. And then for those users who need additional things, like for example, the export to Power Automate and integration with Power BI and many, many more, Visio Plan 2 might be the right template and the right tool to choose because it delivers some of the more advanced templates and especially add-ons. This was a very quick overview of the Visio plans, but there is one thing we don't need an overview for, and that is the Visio file format. It has not changed since the version 2013, where the new Visio file format, the XML-based file format, was introduced. So whether you work with Plan 2 or Visio Standard 2013, you always are able to exchange files just like that between all the users. There is never an import, export, or anything necessary. All these Visio versions use the same file format and the same file. So in very short, if you need Word export for process diagrams, Power BI integration, PowerPoint export, Visio Data Visualizer, which means give Visio an Excel file, it creates a diagram for you, offline capability, that's Plan 2. Everything else for all the other users who are regular Visio users is Plan 1. And for those users who I personally call them the now and then Visio user, who now and then need to create a basic diagram, Visio and Microsoft 365 is the right tool to create still very, very sophisticated diagrams. This was just a very quick overview. I hope you found it interesting and useful. Thank you very much for your attendance, and I wish you a great day.